Hey guys, Upgraded Rotom here, coach of the San Diego Pachirisus, and welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to be giving a breakdown of my new draft team for the Pokeball division of the League of Extraordinary Trainers, aka the LET. For the first pick of the draft, I decided to grab myself Walking Wake. Walking Wake is an amazing water and dragon type Pokemon with a total base stat of 590 and an amazing ability in Protosynthesis. This Pokemon not only shines with stats and abilities, but also with its signature move, Hydro Steam. Hydro Steam is a base 80 water special attack that, unlike other water moves, has its damage increased in Sun instead of being decreased. If I get a chance to set it up in Sun, this mon clicks buttons and hits hard with other moves such as Draco Meteor and even Flamethrower. My next pick for the draft also happened to be an ancient beast known this time as Sandy Shox. With the same ability as Walking Wake and a base stat total of 570, Sandy Shox is a very welcome member of the team. This mon shines in its speed and special attack stats, so they were able to hop into a situation and hit heavy with things such as Thunderbolt, Flash Cannon, and even Terra Blast. That's right, Terra Blast! Sandy Shox is also going to be one of the three Terra Captains on my team this season, so not only will it be a threat on its own, but with the ability to have free Terra for any matchup we need, Shox will surely be a threat to anyone who isn't prepared. After I made my first two picks, I wanted to draft something to add a little bit of synergy and support to the team, so I decided to grab the one and only Pelipper. Now originally I had wanted to grab something like Torkoal, but unfortunately that guy was grabbed in round 2 of the draft from a different coach. The good news is, Pelipper still has an amazing synergy with our team, and with its ability Drizzle setting up the rain for Wake, Hydro Steam can still hit hard and it lowers the damage of any fire-type move that my opponent may wish to bring. Not only does it provide support for others, but with its own rain, Pelipper can hit my opponents with its own water moves and hit with 100% accurate hurricanes. After Pelipper, I decided to grab my grounded poison type in Salazzle. Salazzle's base stat of 440 and ability Corrosion will be valuable to our team, and here's why. Corrosion allows Salazzle to poison anything, including steel types and other poison types. This, combined with its fast speed tier, guarantees if I want to toxic something, then it's getting toxicked, whether you like it or not. Salazzle is also an amazing fairy resist, as it resists it 4 times effective. And if I decide to run Sun for a battle, then my fire type moves like Flamethrower are going to be powered up like crazy. Next up on the draft list, I wanted to add a little mon that could be both support and offense at the same time, so I grabbed Tornadus Incarnate. Being one of the only pure flying types of the game, Torn is amazing for fighting and grass types, and with moves like Break Wind Storm and Hurricane, Tornadus will tear through them. Another benefit Tornadus has is its abilities. Prankster is an amazing ability, as if I choose so, I can have priority on my status moves such as Tailwind, Nasty Plot, or even Taunt. If I choose not to have that, then I bring Defiant. Defiant will give me a double attack stat boost if any of my other stats are lowered, including my attack stat. This essentially gives me a free boost in power. After Tornadus, I figured we should grab a good fairy type Pokemon, and so we're picking up Screamtail. Screamtail is the perfect support mon with its insane HP, defense, special defense, and speed stats, all being above or just about 100. These stats, coupled with the versatility of its moves such as Stealth Rock, Trick, and Calm Mind, allow me to treat this mon as sort of a multi-purpose tool and bring whatever set I may believe will give me the most value for the week. On top of that, Protosynthesis allowing me to boost whatever stat may be my highest for the week's battle is just the cherry on top as to why I wanted to draft this Pokemon. With the excitement I got from Screamtail, I figured let's take one last blast from the past and grab Hisuian Decidueye. Decidueye is an amazing Pokemon to pick up with its great attack stat and high defenses. This mon shines, however, with its hidden ability and signature move, those of course being Triple Arrows and Scrappy. Triple Arrows is a triple threat where it can either crit, lower defense, or, if I'm faster than my opponent, even make them flinch. Couple that with the ability Scrappy, allowing them to hit fighting type moves against ghost types, and you've got the ultimate combo. Decidueye is also one of this season's Terra Captains, which will allow me to remove my terrible 4x weakness to flying type and replace it with something that may be better, such as steel or even water, in order to fully take advantage of what Decidueye is capable of. With all the hype of the team building, I decided to relax a little at the beach, where we meet our next team member, Palossand. While true, this haunted sandcastle is a little slow. This mod makes up for it in its defense stat. With a base stat of 110, this Sand Guardian will even make Poseidon quiver before him. With moves like Earth Power, Shadow Ball, and Giga Drain, Palossand will take hits and keep on taking them. Palossand will also be our final Terra Captain for the season, with the hope to pair its ability Water Compaction, raising its defense every time it's hit with a water move, with a type that will better suit the situation and not allow for Palossand to be hit with a super effective move in order to have that ability activate. Second to last, our next pick for the team is Alolan Persian. Alolan Persian gives me a mon that has yet another amazing speed stat and two great abilities. Fur Coat will increase my base defenses with the drawback of essentially giving me a fire type weakness. However, with the rain set up by the others in my team, we can neutralize this threat and bring out the ability's full potential. On the other hand, Technician boosting our weaker damaging moves such as Fake Out and even Bite will allow us to spread more damage than our opponent may be expecting of us. Finally, for our last pick, I guess we find history repeating itself, and we grab a Pokemon from the Goomy line, but this time, it's Hisuian Sligoo. Hisuian Sligoo is an amazing bulky Pokemon, especially with Eviolite, and with the added Steel type to the previous Mono Dragon, we neutralize our weakness to Fairy, while giving ourselves a super effective way to hit them back. The abilities in Sapsipper and Shell Armor will also be very beneficial, with Sapsipper giving us a grass-type immunity and Shell Armor granting us that we don't get hit with any critical hits. And with that, this team is concluded. Let me know your thoughts on what I drafted and maybe even some fun strats to try with them in the upcoming battles. Speaking of, stay tuned for my week 1 battle against my opponent Foreside and their team, the Carolina Golurks. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.